My name is Markus. I'm from Germany, from the University of Magdeburg, which is near to Berlin. And there I'm working as a scientific staff member in the workgroup Data and Knowledge Engineering of Professor Nürnberger. And I'm also here on behalf of Tatjana Gossen, whose research field is directly focusing on IR systems for kids. So, and today I'd like to present you a knowledge journey, a web search interface for kids. So I'd like to follow this agenda, a short motivation, some related work, give you some information on the proposed solution, the search user interface, and also some information on the evaluation of what we've done. And at the end, I will give you a short summary. So starting with motivation. So children are one of the, if not the fastest growing user group in the World Wide Web. You can distinguish between different age ranges, like you can see here in this diagram, 6 to 7 years, 8 to 9, 10 to 11, and 12 to 13 years. So basically, children use the internet for entertainment, watching YouTube. But there's also an increasing role in education. So 54% of them search for information for school and at least once per week. And 42% of all kids use a search engine to do so. So special search engines has been developed for children, but as you can see here, they are not that perfect. If you're typing in a misspelled word like science, for instance, we added here an additional H, so it's science or something, the system is giving just an error log. So it was wrong, and try new. So as you can see, not all children succeed in information inquiry. Especially misspelled words are a huge problem. And if you analyze it, considering different age ranges, you can see here in the diagram that especially the youngest ones, between 6 and 7 years, that 33% of them don't know very well how to do it, but they at the end find something using this IR system. And 14% of them are quite worse, since they cannot do it well, and they seldom find information they are looking for. So especially younger children have difficulties. And the reason is children do not have the same abilities and knowledge as adults. Obvious, but not addressed by search engines so far. There has been done a lot of related work in the area of information-seeking behavior, so search strategies has been analyzed. We found out there's a catalog-oriented search and also a keyword-oriented search, which one can use, and also some research on navigation style, relevance, judgment has been done. And on the other side, on the front-end side, if you say so, there we have the web interfaces for children, where we have considered screen design, user interactions, and therefore, some interface concepts appear, such as TED-IR, Collage, Juice, Show and Tell, and some more. And here on this slide, you have some impression how these interfaces for kids look like. So basically, it is catalog-based search, so some given topics where the kids can choose from. But if we have if we take a closer look on it and try to find out whether they do support different aspects, not all of them perform well in this case. So search user interfaces for kids should provide emotional support, language support, cognitive support, memory support, interaction, and relevance support. And I come to this in a minute, what these all are. Let's start with emotional support. Here the challenge is, based on Erikson's theory of psychosocial development, children require emotional support and the feeling of success. So, and our proposed solution is to provide help to support the search process to avoid frustration. And we also provide a guidance figure that captures children's failures. For instance, if the system is getting no results or spelling mistakes appeared, this guidance figure would explain how to do better. So on the left picture, you can see four guidance figures the kid can choose from, can select from. And on the right picture, we have an example where a search query was misspelled and the guidance figure is offering the correct opportunity. So the second one is language support. So the challenge is children read slowly and are still learning to write, especially the youngest one of 6 and 7 years. So they also have often limited domain knowledge and difficulties with typing. So there are problems with query formulation and also spelling errors. The solution might be that we provide different possibilities for children to formulate their information needs. So we combined catalog-based search and keyword-based search by providing a navigation menu with many categories which meet children's information needs and which is image-based and audio-supported in order to handle these difficulties in reading. And we also have this keyword-oriented search with spelling correction mechanisms. And at the bottom, you can see this wheel, which is enhanced in two steps by two-level menu where the kid can choose from. So second one is cognitive support, or the third one is cognitive support. Children in primary school age are in the concrete operational stage of their development. That means children have difficulties with thinking abstractly, and their understanding is limited to concrete and physical concepts. Solution might be to flat hierarchical structure of the menu and to provide familiar metaphors from the physical world, like we've done with this wheel. So memory support. The information processing of children differs from adults. So IR processes cause children's memory to overload. And what often happens, more often than in the case of adult users, is looping behavior. So kids search again and again for the same query during the information seeking process. A solution might be to support users by using personal information management features, a result storage functionality Marty Hirst mentioned this morning, and also search results presentations in the same window. So we like to avoid MODI switches. We like to avoid cognitive overload and a clear back button. And interaction support. So the challenge here is young children's performance and pointing movements, especially handling a computer mouse, is lower than that of adults. So a solution might be a search user interface is operated via simple point and click interactions, and clickable interface elements should be large enough to be easily hit. And also the font sizes should be larger or equal to 14 points. And the last one is relevance support. Here the challenge is difficulties to judge the relevance of the retrieved documents to the kid's information need, and also difficulties to determine the most relevant and the best documents. Solution might be a child-suitable form of results presentation, which supports children's judgment of results relevance and provides relevance clues. And each result item has a website image and a textual description, so to address several age groups. Results are displayed using a cover flow technique, and cover flow also allows users to concentrate on one item at a time. It also does not require complex interactions. So here we are. This is a screenshot from the interface. I will show you now a video where an example interaction has happened. The first is the kid is asked to select a guidance figure. You have this pirate scenario. You will see in a minute why this is of advantage, but just an example. And after selecting the guidance figure, it appears here. And here on the left, you have this pie chart menu, and on the top, this entry field, which we are all familiar with. And then the kid is typing in Venus and gets some information on this planet. And here we tested a misspelling. So here the correct query was offered to the user, and he or she can select from the results. And alternatively, the kid could use this pie chart menu, which you cannot hear, but we also have audio support. So each category will be mentioned via audio. So if the kid is interested in saving a result, I can click on it, view, browse it, and select it in this treasure chest. And with each item added, the treasure chest becomes bigger and bigger to reflect this. It also, the kid can also open this treasure chest, go through these results in this book form, take a look at the web page preview, see the snippet, even can open it, leave a comment, and stuff like this. So this was the video. So yeah, here again, what I've already explained, so it's the interaction path, which is possible, a little bit more simplified. So basically, Knowledge Journey enables children of primary school age to perform textual information retrieval, ad hoc search, and also some kind of exploration. And it is enhanced by personal information management feature. So now we did an evaluation, and the study design was as the following. So we did a comparative user study. We rebuilt Google for this, or the Google interface. Since we had a closed data set, and we liked to have both interface variants the same data set. So we built up a simple interface, which should be Google-like, since we have this fixed backend using. So it was well-defined answer-oriented search tasks. We had within subjects, Latin square blocking design. So each kid used all variants, but in a different order. And our research questions were, what search user interface do young children prefer and why? So is it Google or is it our proposed solution? What is children's attitude towards new interface elements like this guidance figure, audio support, the pie menu, or the treasure chest? And how can both user interfaces be improved? So we had this open door day at the university. There were also a lot of kids with their parents. And we managed to get 28 participants trying out our system. And fortunately, it was half and half, so 14 female kids and 14 boys. And in the age range between 7 and 12, so the average was 9.5 years. These kids use the internet, two of them every day, most of them at least once a week. As I said in the beginning, they play online games, watch videos on YouTube, and they search information for school. So 26 participants, so most of them are using Google. So even if we have these special children search interfaces, they are not used. So at the end, we found out that 17 out of 28 participants would preferred Knowledge Journey, so our proposed solution, and 5 of them liked both user interfaces, so the Google-like interface and the knowledge journey. We have some detailed information on web design, result presentation, and some more, but I will skip this because I'm running out of time. But we can go back if you like to say, if you're interested in during the discussion. So we analyze also guidance, figure, menu. Most of the things were performed quite good. So to sum it up, both user interfaces should have the following improvements, also Google and our proposed solution, that the background of a result output page should be adaptable, and present pictures should be relevant to the search query. Different kinds of graphical user interface personalizations were asked for, including changing color, different elements of the result snippets, and so on. And also textual summary of a web page should be long enough, probably more than one sentence. Maybe we had it a little bit too simplified. And the search user interface should better support children in locating the relevant information on the web page. So improvements which were asked for this classic keyword-oriented search user interface. So each result element should be clearly separated from the rest. And it should have a thumbnail of the corresponding web page. So kids would ask for this. And the search user interface should show a clear back button or present the search result in the same window, like by using iframes. And the new graphical user interface elements like the guidance figure, wheeled menu, and treasure chest can enhance the user experience and was wished to be in this Google-like interface. So, and some asked improvements for the knowledge journey UI was a vertical results list, which would offer a better or faster overview of results. In case of desktop computers which have a relative large screen. And it was also asked for the possibility of voice gender personalization. So let's come to a conclusion and an outlook. Our contribution was basically that we summarized the state of the art in the field of HCIR for young users. You can read it up in the paper, which will be published later. And we specified challenges and suggested solution in web search interface design for young users. We developed this prototype of a web search interface for children of primary school age. And also a contribution was to do this comparative user study we did to evaluate our search interface against the classic, if not the classic, search interface. So and in the future, we would like to evaluate further aspects of knowledge journeys, usability, especially effectiveness and efficiency, which should have analyzed in more detail. Thank you very much for your attention. Questions are welcome.